Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to try to finish painting this wall really quickly while she jumps on the bed, of course.
Hey, Mommy! So, yes,
I hear you. Be careful. Oh, no, careful, Mommy, careful. You can't fit.
This is on my way.
No, it's okay. You want to turn around to see you?
Mommy, here. I want to
It's okay.
Move.
You can't get through. You have to go under. Okay. So hopefully I can finish doing this very quickly. So let's go.
You don't understand, you don't understand what you do to me when you hold his hand. We were meant to be, but it's just a fate. Made it so we had to walk away. 'Cause we're on fire,
So I just finished this little bit of can that was here, and I finished most of, I don't know if you can see it, I mean it's still wet up there of course, but I finished most of that, so hopefully I can take this tape off today so it can look like a picture frame, and then I will get a picture frame from like Hobby Lobby for the saying on the wall, but I don't think you can see, but it looks like most of it was done.
I seen up here.
As you can see, she's trying to help. But most of the wall, you can still see the paint's wet. I had a few little spots that I had to clean up. But I'm hoping that I can take this tape off. Let's see if I pan back, if you can see, minus the tripod. Don't mind the tripod or the painty fingers. But yeah, so it should. And then the top is done. See how I get this out of the frame. I don't know how, why it's in the frame. But the top should be done. All this is done. It just has to dry. So the wall, this wall's finished. So it'll look really nice soon.
You don't understand. You don't understand what you do to me when you hold his hand. We were meant to be, but it's just a fate. Made it so we had to walk away. 'Cause we're on fire, we're on fire, we're on fire now. Yeah, we're on fire, we are on fire, we're on fire now. I don't care what people say when we're together. You know I wanna be the one who holds you in the sleeve. It's 4 a.m. and I know that you're with him. I wonder if he knows that I touched your skin. And if he feels my traces in your head. I'm sorry, love, but I don't really care. 'Cause we're on fire, we're on fire, we're on fire now. Yeah, we're on fire.
I finished around the closet. I finished the walls, so all the walls in this room are done. The only thing is the ceiling and the trim, which I am probably going to pay somebody to do because it would probably kill my neck to do the ceiling part, so no. Yeah, and I want all the ceilings painted and all the trim, and
I really don't want to do it. No. So I will have a friend do it for me that does painting. So that'll be taken care of. But for today's, that was my thing for today, was to finish my bedroom painting finally. So then I can get some. I was thinking of taking, I have these crates, I use them underneath the bed for storage and stuff, but I was thinking about getting two of them and screwing them into the wall for bookshelves, but I'm not really sure if that's really what I do, so it's like a thought and process. But Maddie's enjoying her bath, and she's calling me, of course, to come get her. I'm coming to wash your hair, so we'll get back to this later.
Fix the elevator?
The one you intentionally left broken to drive out your
tenants.
Today
I went to Dollar Tree and I got some things and Target for the cabinet. Fast forward some things from IKEA, so hopefully there'll be an organizational kitchen slash mudroom video shortly as soon as everything comes in.
To drive these freeloaders out.
I've talked about this cabinet in the kitchen that I hate more than anything in this world.
You're under so much stress.
That's when you lost it.
I feel like, it's so deep and takes up so much room, but has nothing goes in it. Nothing works. Nothing. I tried plates. It doesn't work. I tried the cups. It doesn't work. I tried snacks. It doesn't work because you can't see anything. So a couple of my girlfriends had an idea if I took the shelf out and I put in a Lazy Susan. So I'm looking into doing something like that, like a big Lazy Susan that would be like in a bottom cabinet. I'm going to try to put it in my top cabinet. Hopefully I figure out something, because it's a lot of space. It's just unused. It's just, it makes no sense whatsoever. But my mudroom, I use, I did build shelves in it during the quarantine time. And I put like my paints and stuff for outside, you know, my handy stuff, you know, for handyman in the house, which I do. I put a lot of that stuff out there that's easy, that I go to that I need really quickly instead of having it in the basement. But my girlfriend had an idea. Well, she did it with her. She made a pantry and she used a Billy bookshelf from IKEA. So I ordered one. They didn't have two of them, but I ordered one to start with to put in my mudroom to alleviate some pantry type stuff that's in my kitchen out. So I'll have more room in my kitchen for everyday stuff that I use all the time. So it'll just be a little bit easier. So it will make the kitchen look less stuffy and a little bit more organized. And then they did have one cabinet that I'm looking into getting. Hopefully, every time I go online tonight to look for it, it keeps saying it's sold out. So I'm hoping, because I had the idea that it would fit perfectly in my mudroom and it was three shelves, so it would be able to hold my KitchenAid mixer on the bottom because that's the heaviest, my air fryer, and my Instapot, which would give me my big cabinet that's next to my stove back to me if I put those three appliances in there. So it would be a lot easier. And then I was going to take that, there's a really thin shelf in there, and I was thinking if I could take a piece of wood and paint it to match that inside of that, because it's painted like that chalkboard white. But I was thinking if I have all those little, you know, those little plastic things that go into the shelves to move the shelves back and forth. My idea is to take that, take another shelf to make it come out a little bit more instead of such a tiny shelf, to move like the small appliances and then maybe like lids and stuff like that for my pots and pans, and organize that a little bit better because it could come out a little bit more. I could use it a little bit more. So that's the plan. So hopefully that video will, the idea will come to me and the video will come with the organization. So it should hopefully be up this week. But in the meantime, it's a paint with me, clean, and I really didn't do much meal prep this week. So we'll see what I come up with for tomorrow. But we will call it a night and see you guys tomorrow. Bye.
Understand what you do to me when you hold his hand. We were meant to be, but it's just a fate. Made it so we had to walk. walk away. 'Cause we're on fire, we're on fire, we're on fire now. Yeah, we're on fire, we are on fire, we're on fire now. I don't care what people say when we're together. You know I wanna be the one to hold you when you sleep. I just wanted to be you and not forever. I know you wanna leave, so come on, baby. It's 4 a.m. and I know that you're with him. I wonder if he knows that I touched your skin. And if he feels my traces in your hair. I'm sorry, love, but I don't really care. 'Cause we're on fire, we're on fire, we're on fire.
I'm trying to put together these shelves. I'm probably gonna put one or two on the counters, and then the other one, I have one on in one cabinet. Don't mind how dark it looks in here. Let's see if this ring light works a little bit better. Still can't totally figure this thing out. But so I'm gonna put one or two on the counter to give me a little bit elevate the counter space, or I'll put one on the counter and three in the cabinets. This is part of me trying to fix the cabinet in the corner. I most likely will get a big lazy Susan for it, but in the meantime, I'm just gonna try to work with what I've been able to purchase at IKEA, Dollar Tree, and Target, to make the cabinets a little bit more accessible. And then I did order, I can't pick it up till Thursday, of course, but I did order like a Billy bookshelf for my mudroom to kind of make that more of a pantry. In there, I do have shelves in there that I've probably said it before, that I have like my paints and stuff like that for the house. So I'm probably gonna make half that shelf like outdoor type stuff, or indoor like home improvement stuff. And then the other shelf, there's three shelves on the wall, so the other ones I'm probably gonna put like maybe cleaning supplies, household goods, however I wanna work it. And then the Billy bookshelf that I'm gonna put on the floor, I believe I should be able to fit two in there, but if not, I'm gonna do two and one single, one of the single bookshelves, because my plan on the single bookshelf is to be able to get my big cabinet back in my kitchen by being able to put three of I shouldn't say everyday appliances, but I do use them more than anything else. So my air fryer, my Instapot, and my KitchenAid mixer. I keep one KitchenAid mixer in the basement on the shelves, and I keep my crock pots and stuff downstairs in my downstairs pantry. But I think if I utilize that space, then it's gonna make this cabinet a lot more accessible, and maybe have room for my pots and pans. Goal. I mean, my kitchen isn't huge, but it's not small either, because it's pretty open. I think you can probably see the like white cabinets behind me. It's supposed to be kind of like a coffee bar thing, but my toaster oven takes up way too much space, and it's like a toaster oven convection oven. So I've been contemplating getting rid of that and getting the Ninja one that takes up less space because it folds up. Because it is something I do use quite often. It's just in the wrong space. And this is more of like a snack station. It's got canned goods, I can't think of that, like aluminum foil, plastic wrap, parchment paper, that kind of stuff is all like over there. And then like some snacks for Maddie, cans of stuff that Steve likes to eat and stuff like that, because he can eat junk food and I can't. But that's all like in that cabinet, so I find it's kind of like an overflow. But I've had it for a while, and I'm really, really tossing and turning, getting like a island that I could order from, not IKEA. I saw them on Wayfair for under $500, and one comes with like little benches, like stools, so like Maddie could eat on it, and it's a butcher block top, so it would be kind of nice for like meal prep and stuff like that, because you can move it back and forth. And then get rid of this because it's done its purpose. I've probably had it for 7 years now. So, I mean, it still does a good, you know, does what it's there for. But in the meantime, I'm trying to come up with a plan to get Maddie to, I mean, she still like sits in her high chair to eat her dinner and her lunch. Breakfast sometimes is like on the go. So she'll eat like half a banana or, you know, her little muffins or whatever. She's not a huge breakfast fan unless it's my day off and I'm home cooking. So I make eggs and sausage or pancakes and sausage or something like that, and she'll eat it. But she tends to only like her high chair, and she's not really big, but she still likes her high chair for lunch and dinner. So I really want to get her transitioned to kind of like a table, but the way my house is set up, I never set it up like, I set up my room that's supposed to be your dining room, which I find wasted space because I just don't need a table. I would rather just eat really quick and be done with it. But I set it up as a sitting area, and it's great for like my dogs, and as someone watch TV, we have a TV in here, and I have a big hutch over here that could be reworked also to take extra glasses and stuff like that, wine glasses and everything. Which is a whole other project because there's DVDs and stuff in there that really need to be gone through, photo albums, whole other organizational videos. So basically by the end of 2021, the house should be completely organized. Let's hope. 2020 was not remodeling it, but like I painted all my kitchen cabinets, I redid the grout on my floor, I painted almost every wall in this house, but now with my ceiling in my living room, I'm going to have the, well, all the ceilings need to be repainted, all the trim. But I just finished my bedroom this weekend, so all I have to do is get two picture frames for my sayings that I think I'm going to do in white. And then I have two walls in here in the sitting room that I really want shiplapped. I also want a wall possibly in my bathroom shiplapped, but I'm not 100% sure yet. So everything's just, you know, when you have a house, you kind of come up with ideas, and luckily my boyfriend's pretty good about not really caring how the house is decorated or anything, because technically it's mine. So he's always been really like, how are we going to decorate? And I'm like, okay, well, here goes for my farm style, chic or farm style house, because, you know, I am a country girl at heart. But in the meantime, I'm going to try to see if I can get some of this done while Maddie's sleeping, and I will show you how it all turns out. You don't understand, you don't understand what you do to me when you hold his hand. We were meant to be, but it just a fate made it so we had to walk away. So-called pantry cabinet with all my spices, medicine, all the BS, you know. It looks like I can't stand it, so hopefully we'll get that fixed. Then over here, I've got this one a little bit more organized for Maddie's cups, bowls, enough place for us every day, her plates, and just some of like my medicine and stuff, and Maddie's, Steve's is in the other cabinet. I'm not like committed to this cabinet yet, but at least it looks a little bit better. So my trouble cabinet, this cabinet. So I decided to use this I bought two of these, and it seems to have like
a deep cabinet. It doesn't fit in my other cabinets, which was my original objective. So I put my extra plates here for now. And in the back, you can see glasses we don't use all the time. So I decided, because this cabinet is annoying, that I would put stuff that I don't use all the time all the way in the back. And then I put some snacks right here. And then I realized that I forgot I bought this huge Lazy Susan. So is what I was gonna do is take all my small spices and all my small stuff that can go underneath that, and then I'm gonna stick it in there and hopefully it'll work. This is my plan. And then my everyday ones, I used Catherine from Do It on a Dime's idea to take the two cake pans, and I'll show you. Like, you take the marbles, you take the cake pan. So my spices that I use more often, I'm gonna put in this cabinet, I think, or on the bottom of the other cabinet that I had as a pantry. But this I use this Lazy Susan that I got from Target to put my syrups, my apple cider vinegars, and my sprays and stuff like that, and then a few of my little baking things that I need, and then I haven't found a place for that. But it's all a work in progress, of course, so hopefully we'll make some progress. Okay, so I picked these up to try to store Maddie's clothes better in the drawers. So I'm going to put these together and we'll see how they come out.
You don't understand, you don't understand what you do to me when you hold his hand.
So not bad for $6 for two of these. So I think they will go in Maddie's drawers to help me with her clothes. So we'll see. Hi guys. I'm having trouble with my camera, of course, today. So I've already folded Maddie's clothes, so I'm going to try to come up with a way to fill these up. So let's see.
You don't understand, you don't understand what you do to me when you hold his hand. We were meant to be, but it just a fate made it so we had to walk away.
Made a pile. The basket is closed. It still do fit Maddie, so I just have to make room in the second drawer for her with reorganizing it a little bit. So that'll be done. And then this pile is all closed. Now, I tend to keep Maddie's clothes because I do hope that I will be able to have another child. But if I don't, I save them for my girlfriends or special outfits that I always want to keep that, you know, somebody gave to her, or I hand them down to my friends. So this pile will go upstairs in one of the boxes that I put in the attic. So we've made a decent pile, so I'm pretty good about that. And then she still has this basket full of clothes, and of course, you know, in spring and summer she'll probably need a few new things. She is still kind of small for her age, so she still can wear lots of 18-month 2T clothes. She's still really not into 3T. She's not big enough for that, but these clothes all, I will say, she has put almost every outfit to good use, and then there were some outfits that she outgrew when she was a baby very quickly, so she does have a lot of dresses and stuff upstairs that I still need to go through to donate to friends, babies, and stuff like that. So I do have a girlfriend that's about to have twin girls, so I will definitely be putting together something for her with some of my hand-me-downs. So not bad for our little organization, and I'll show you Maddie's drawer how it looks.
Okay, so this is the finished product of Maddie's drawer. It actually looks really good. She's got some t-shirts, like, for her regular clothes in the back. A couple sweatpants, a lot of her pajamas, mainly pajamas because that's what Daddy keeps her in. But she does have quite a lot. But still, it actually looks really nice, and she still could put a few things on top. But I tried the, why can't I think of her name? The tidy Marie something, I'll think of it, method, because she always says to, like, roll the clothes to make more room for them, so they actually fold pretty nice and neat and they look really nice. So all in all, great little organization product for Maddie's clothes.